Shit, the recording split. Let me check that quick. Okay, I need the curse's exact wording for this.
We need to get this right. Words of the curse were, man shall sit and dine with you at your table. No spoon you have shall say to you, never again shall you wish to spy your reflection in the mirror.
No spoon shall sate you. I don't see how that would mean that we have to swap the spoons. And let's eat not using spoons. That... would that make sense? Because if we... we can't... hold on.
Need to get this right. Words of the curse were... man shall sit in...
which we are...
spoon you have shall see.
Okay.
Never again shall you wish to spy your reflection in the mirror.
So we need to eat without using a spoon, right? Because we're at the table, I'm a willing guest, and if no spoon will sate her, or him, it, then we can't use a spoon. And swapping spoons wouldn't mean shit. So we need to eat not using spoons.
Spoons. No, that won't work. You've been looking for a spoon that would feed you, but there's no such spoon. We need to eat without spoons.
Oh god, Geralt. Good luck. Ew. Ew. That is... oh, gross.
Open your eyes. You need to see your likeness.
Did it work? What the hell's going on? I don't know if that means I did something... oh my god, look at Geralt.
Expected. Need to see what happened to the white. Won't be hard to find given its stench.
I want to find out if we lifted the curse or not. That would... I hope I did. Went outside. Excuse me. Oh my god. Oh my god. Not now, buddy. All right, you fuck. Would you just look, come here and die? There you go. I need to find out if this worked. How'd the stench get up there? I can see a blue thing. Excuse me, are you free?
Shh, easy. Not gonna hurt you.
Eat. I must eat.
Oh my god, it worked.
Someplace safe.
Just, you know, glowing blue, and is that normally what happens after a curse is lifted? And how, is, can she eat now? Can she use a spoon? Can she eat with people at a table?
So I took her by the hand and led her here. Seemed the only sensible place for her.
You did the right thing, sir. She should recover quickly.
Oh, she brought me, or we brought her.
I shall see to everything. She is safe here and in good hands. She'll soon be back on her feet.
Might actually take a while. She hadn't eaten anything in over 100 years when I found her.
Horrid. Whatever brought this about?
Told me her story on the way here. Her name's Marlena. She was once the very beautiful and proud heiress to the Trastamara estate. One evening, when she was holding a banquet for friends, a beggar came to her gate seeking alms. He had a bowl and a spoon with him. He sat outside her fence and waited.
I've heard of the custom. An ancient rite of hospitality that obliges one to give food and drink to such a guest lest he depart hungry. To neglect the custom is to bring great misfortune down upon oneself.
Marlena didn't care a whit for the old customs. She drove the man off, saying she'd rather feed the leftovers from her feast to her dogs than to give the beggar anything. The beggar then broke his spoon, cast a curse. She was beautiful, so he said she'd never wish to look at herself in the mirror again. Since she adored feasts, he swore no one would ever wish to sit and dine with her. And as she even refused him the crumbs from her table, he swore she'd never find a spoon in the world that would sate her hunger.
A harsh punishment. I imagine lifting the curse was hardly simple.
Curses are tricky. They play on irony. Always gotta figure out what the catch is. Marlena had spent decades looking for a way to lift it. Transformed into a wight, she stole spoons and lured folk into her home, trying each time to get them to dine with her. Didn't work.
So what did?
Someone had to sit down and share a meal with her. Of their own free will. They had to eat without using spoons and make her look at her reflection.
That's it? That was all it required?
Simplest solutions are sometimes the last that come to mind. Besides, when you're a wight, it's pretty damn hard to find willing human company for a feast.
I imagine so. But most importantly, it is now over. Please, don't worry. She will be in good hands here.
Thanks. Gotta get back to my business now. See you soon.
Awesome, guys. We're level 45. Can I talk to her?
Tasty. So... wonderful. Thank you.
And I know what it feels like when I go and, like, I don't eat for an entire 24 hours and I'm dead, and I just go and eat, and it's so delicious. I cannot imagine what it'd be like to not eat for 100 fucking years. Like, holy shit. There's hunger, and then there's hunger. Well, let's take our shit back to Regis. And then we'll come back here and scope out what's new with the house. And see what else I might be able to renovate and order. I hear bubbling. What is with the guy with the helmet on? Or with the hat?
Think your friend's hand will make friends.
What is that?
You've clearly honed your sense of humor. But we are not cannibals, Geralt. I took a fragment of tissue from the hand. It will suffice to prepare some residence.
What did you do with the rest?
I cremated it, as our codex commands. The raven told me you'd acquired the necessary ingredient.
Pretty helpful creatures. Calling them often?
I try not to overdo it. But they can be so useful. As they were now, when I merely needed to be sure I could arrive in time should things go sour.
Managed fine alone, but thanks for the thought. Gonna need much longer to finish brewing resonance? Mentioned a last ingredient, too. What about that?
That, I fear, might prove troublesome. You see, to use the concoction to summon the memories of one, the solution must contain the blood of another specimen of the same species.
Shouldn't be a problem. I happen to know a higher vampire who should be willing to help. Right, Regis?
It's not that simple, I'm afraid. While you were away, I tried my damnedest to identify a replacement, but alas, none such exists.
Not sure I understand what the problem is. Can't we just draw some of your blood?
The blood must be in an agitated state. As I'm certain you know, higher vampires can change their corporeal shell. As our flesh changes, so does our blood's chemical composition. To make a long story short, I shall need to induce in myself a state of strong psychokinetic arousal. In brief, madness, rabidity. That stands to be very, very dangerous.
Oh, I see. Okay. Who for? Who do you think, dumbass?
Dangerous? Why? I mean, you'll still be you, right?
True. But I should be highly agitated, in a state of fury. You know better than I that fury cannot be controlled. If you've ever seen an enraged vampire, you know very well that all who find themselves nearby will be in grave danger.
How will we handle that? I'd rather not have you lunge at me, claws extended.
That makes two of us. But worry not. I've thought it through very thoroughly. Details to follow soon.
All right. So what do you want to do?
We shall visit Tesha Mudna, an ancient vampire estate. There we will find cages suspended in the air. I will enter one, be confined. You will lure beasts there. Beasts you will then kill. The bloodletting should prove profuse. Abundant enough so that the blood scent will drive me mad. Wild.
And then he'll rip through the metal cage bars, and then I'll have to put him down, or slice his dick off and use the blood, and then hopefully run away in time. And then we can sew the leftover dick onto this skeleton over here. This Indiana Jones guy. Or Michael Jackson guy. I don't know. He does have a glove on.
Tesha Mudna. What's it like?
It is a place of torment. A torture chamber. Long ago, shortly after we'd arrived in this world, one among us named Kagmar developed such a taste and lust for human blood that in one night he could imbibe an entire village. This brought trouble on the entire species. Common folk wearied quickly of living in constant fear. They began to hunt us, seek the aid of mages and witches in tracking us down.
So what? Not like they could ever hope to kill you.
But they were bothersome. Forgive the comparison, but when did you last enjoy mosquitoes buzzing around your head? In any case, the other vampires decided something had to be done. Kagmar had to be caught and punished. A torture chamber was thus outfitted in the dungeons of Tesha Mudna. Inside it, a cage made entirely of a special alloy of silver, dalvinite, and meteorite steel. Kagmar was captured and locked in the cage, sat there over 2 centuries, driven to fury time after time, never able to escape. Thus I know the cage will withstand the fury to which we shall drive my humble being.
Oh, okay. Hopefully, you mean.
See no reason to dawdle. Tesham,
hopefully.
Take me there.
In a moment. Just one last thing.
What was that?
Blood. Oh, the last favor the raven did me. I've also taken some sangurium. Sharpens one's sense of smell. One drop of blood shall smell like a gallon to me now.
You crazy? You're a recovering addict.
Your outrage warms my heart, Geralt. But you must remain calm. I have no choice.
You killed the birdie! Oh, don't go. As don't become enraged here.
The die is cast. High time we set off for Tesha Mudna. My head's spinning already, and you're starting to smell quite tasty.
Yeah, let's get a move on.
You're starting to scare me.
Oh my god. You're starting to smell quite tasty. We didn't really get any of these cinematic shots in the main game, did we? I don't remember anything like this, where it pans around. This is like the second or third time this has happened.
We have arrived. The sacrificial chamber of torture and torment lies underground.
Sure you know what you're doing?
I can only hope I do. Please, let's go. The longer we delay, the less control I shall have of my faculties. I'd really prefer not to hurt you.
Yeah, but I'm Geralt. I can just kill you, and if you happen to kill me, there's a something called a checkpoint save. Not sure if you've heard of it.
You lead.
And then there's a dead guy who is covered in blood. Is that his...
Skurvers must be getting close to their feeding ground.
Correct. I told you there'd be danger.
That is disgusting. Is that his guts are like all strung out across the ground.
Beyond this wall lies...
an ancient vampire dungeon. Seen a lot of things in my time. Nothing quite like this, though.
My, I feel honored. A man with such a wealth of experience, yet I'm about to show him something new. Now, to open it.
How the hell?
It's an ancient form of protection against unwanted guests. The mechanism which releases the latch reacts only to a high vampire's blood.
Tricky mechanisms, a vampire hideout. Fortified, secured. Must have been important to your species once, Toussaint.
It shall always be so. During the conjunction, the gate from our world to this one opened upon this land and no other. This was the first place we saw.
Suddenly a shitload of armor.
Husbandry and care. This for real?
The author observed humans, their behavior, over the many years he spent breeding them. Morally suspect though it may be, it's a thorough survey of the topic.
I picked up, like, a set of armor. Relic? 0 out of 6. What? Killing opponents restores vitality. The amount of vitality restored equals 1%. Of maximum vitality for each element of the set worn. Currently, that amount is 0%. Okay. They're very, very expensive, but I don't think I'm going to use that.
This place. There's evil here. Death hangs in the air.
Yes. Great many beings have breathed their last here.
These boards are like rotted away on the side. That'd be great because we're just gonna break through. How deep does it go? Ooh.
Glyphs are carved into the rock. Coated with blood used to be. They mean something?
They're emblems. Symbols of what you would call tribes. Dispersed throughout the world after the conjunction. My ancestors placed them here to remind us all where we came from.
There's more of this stuff.
Seems your kind assembled a peculiar little library.
Indeed. Though I personally did not lay a hand to it.
What's this symbol mean?
It's the symbol of the Tadet. Those who went east beyond the Blue Mountains.
A symbol that he doesn't want to tell me about?
And this one? Which tribe's this?
Garishan. My tribe, and Deadlaugh's. We both remained in this part of the world.
Guess they just want to give you this full set of armor down here. I like that extra attack power, though.
Cells. Who for?
Ah, disgraceful. It excruciated me so, this particular page of my history. I'd rather not summon the demons of the past if it's all I can do.
At least they died with money.
Whose is this glyph?
I'm a runner. They ventured beyond the sea.
You got some great memory, holy shit. Okay, well now what was that noise? Okay, what the hell is that noise? I don't like it. Get me out of here, please. I'm over-encumbered again?! Oh, son of a bitch. What the fuck, man? What the fuck? That's this 1,000. That's this 1,000. We can drop this. That's okay. We've already looked at that one, though.
What's this symbol mean?
It's the symbol of the Tadet.
Yeah.
Those who went east, beyond the Blue Mountains.
We knew that. Is this the cave here? Or the cage, rather?
Charming place. But what are all those cages for? Mentioned one vampire being kept here.
Yes, well... You see, humanitarians is something my ancestors were not. They concluded Kagmar would best be punished if he were tormented with the scent of blood he could not taste. Thus, they also kept humans here. Humans whose blood they slowly let. Kagmar ranted and raged in pain as those humans slowly bled to death.
That is disgusting.
They treated them like livestock, live bait.
I'd like to be able to turn back time, deny it, but... I can do neither. Feel shame for my brethren. That is all I can do.
Don't take it so hard. Nothing you could have done about it. Let's get to work.
Yeah, and we're about to slaughter some creatures for the same thing, so you know what?
I prepared the bait. Please be so kind and place it. Ideally at the tunnel entrances. The scent will spread most effectively then. Place the bait at the tunnel entrances. Monsters will catch its scent more quickly.
When I think how these tunnels got here, scent shivers.
It was the natural order of things. The place reeked of death and it attracted necrophages.
Oh god, shit's gonna get a little weird. How do I place the bait here? It won't let me. What? Do I have to, like, art, or...? Oh, I do.
Three done. One left. Think this'll work?
I certainly hope so. The stench is so thick, the wager of care is clear to nobody.
I heard something. Necrophages? Is that what I'm gonna have to be attacking?
Bait set. What now?
I shall enter the cage. You must chain me inside. The bars are made of an alloy that will prevent me from transforming into mist.
Kinda thought you wouldn't want to.
I shall be in great pain. My sole thought being to stop that pain. I cannot know what I will do.
This is kind of crazy.
We must hurry. The beasts have caught the sentinels on my head.
See that that cinematic shot right there was awesome.
That the blood.
Someone who's never experienced a vampire's bloodlust does not know the true meaning of thirst.
Safe word. You know, something you'll say when you can't take it anymore.
And what would you do once I uttered it?
Don't know.
Oh, these guys explode. Somehow. Shit.
Please. You won't be able to. We must forge through this. That is all.
Rot fiend.
We just smell the blood.
Fuck you guys. You've got drowner animations and drowner AI. Oh god. And you explode, which is even worse. The fuck is that? Letter. I've never seen one of these before, have I? Oh, okay, hold on. I gotta get out of here. Lots more. Holy shit, guys. No. Let's get out of here. Let's heal. Let's switch to Igni. And miss with Igni. Oh, God. Oh, God, there's so many. I gotta, like, take them down one by one. No, don't get trapped in the corner. Don't do that. I need to Igni all these guys. Explode! Oh, piss. Okay, enough with the auto. Just blow yourself up, Geralt. It's perfectly fine. Oh god, there's like a vampire down here. Well, at least his bloodlust has reached already. Yeah, but there's monsters. Oh my goodness. Well, that scared the catacan off. Terrifying. Oh my god. It's not like any vampire I've ever heard of. Yeah, like you can meditate right in front of that thing's penis.
Get you out of here.
The concoction.
It in this state. Tell me how. I'll help you. Any better?
Far from ideal. And some time must pass before I fully recover. But yes, a bit better, thank you.
Never expected it to be like that. You didn't tell me.
We need not discuss it.
But we do. Because if I'd known you were going to subject yourself to torture...
What would you have done?
Found Detlov some other way.
I did not wish you to use any other way. Did that occur to you?
No, because I thought no being would ever willingly subject itself to that kind of pain. You vampires aren't any different from us in that regard.
I told you. The pain is my way of paying my debt. The enormous debt I owe Detlov. If I had to do it again, I would in a heartbeat.
Oh my god, imagine being starved to death. Like, I mean, not starving to death like that, but being chained in a cage with food everywhere and staying that way until you died. Like, that... And then having people walk up to you while you're there naked in a cage, eating... deep fried chicken right in front of your face and wiggling it around in front of the cage so that the stench of the fresh white meat of the chicken just and the juices splatter everywhere but just out of your reach and you can't that would be the Oh my god.
Resonance. It's ready.
Are you certain you followed the formula? The proportions were exact, the brewing time precise. This is important, Geralt. The slightest deviation could cost even a witcher dearly.
Relax. Got some experience brewing potions.
Very well. In that case, let's begin.
You don't look very well. I think you should lay down and get some sleep first. Look at those polygon scrolls over there. It reminds me of, like, Nintendo 64. Oh my. His eyes were...
Excuse me. I shall only take a moment.
You jumped the queue, sir.
But Count, sir, you must understand. I've a meeting. The Count...
Sir, you were next. Please, take a seat.
Oh, what? Nice.
This gentleman was here first. Step down or you shall regret it.
Fails to realize he was your friend, Count.
Like, nobody would see that's what's... You've... Oh, nice, okay. You don't find many people that are that kind, you know.
It was then I ordered him to give up his seat and step off the stand. If only you'd seen his face. We got him good, didn't we, Detlov?
This is... These flash...
My mother insisted we buy the mill. Curious, eh? At least I've a yarn to spin for friends and associates.
Forgive me.
What?
What the hell? Oh, God. Oh, that's the guy that... What the fuck? I can't watch that. That's disgusting. What the fuck? why did he do it? So we're seeing back to how he met the person and then murdered him.
Awaken.